Honorable Prime Minister of Canada, Mr. Justin Trudeau, ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to all of you. At the onset, I would like to start by extending my warmest wishes to all of you, especially you, Prime Minister, sir, who has come here with your family and made India their home for the last 1 week, and to all the colleagues that you have brought with you, especially those of my community, who have done us proud in your land. India and Canada have shared sound bilateral relations since many decades. Canada has been a home away from home for many Indians. India-Canada relations has become truly multi-dimensional in changing times. The two countries have expanded their cooperation in the realm of trade and commerce, security, energy, education, science and technology. Ladies and gentlemen, today India stands at the cusp of an exciting phase. Under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, we have seen India surging ahead rapidly in economic development. India has taken several initiatives to facilitate ease of doing business. Since 2014, the focus of the government has been to undertake policy changes, improve and modernize infrastructure, upgrade skill sets of people, and provide financial support to young entrepreneurship. These measures have put India on the path of unprecedented economic growth. In the ease of doing business rankings, as mentioned before me, India has improved its position by moving from 130th position to the 100th position. We are determined to work closely with foreign governments, business corporations, banks, international financial institutions towards realizing the goal of inclusive economic development. Several sectors of the Indian economy have been opened up for foreign direct investments. Additionally, the FDI cap on several existing sectors have either been increased or their entry has been transformed into the automatic route. Since the opening up of the Indian economy, the cumulative foreign direct investments so far into India is about $518 billion. Between 2016-17, India received FDI worth $60.08 billion. With the above-mentioned policy measures set in motion, we are confident that the inflow FDI into the country is only expected to increase. While we talk about FDI, I must mention here about the food processing sector. I know that before me you mentioned the 5 E's, but I want to move to the FP, which is food processing, which I truly believe is the potential, the untapped potential, which the world is now looking towards. A $600 billion retail sector in India, out of which 70% is food retail, set to treble to $1.3 trillion by 2020. The second largest population of 1.3 billion people whose demand of food is set to double in the next 5 years. Truly, the potential and the market that we have to offer in this sector is unparalleled anywhere else in the globe. And probably that's one of the reasons why food processing sector has attracted FDI of almost $1 billion every year the last 2 years. India and Canada trade at 2016 stood at Canadian dollars 8.02 billion. So far the total FDI inflow from Canada into India stood at US 0.92 billion. There certainly remains enough scope for improving this figure, and I hope that improvement will happen in the sector which I just mentioned earlier. I urge the business leaders and captains of the industry from both the countries present here to play a more proactive role in bringing together people and businesses. And especially in the medium and the small sector is something that we could all both focus on. Under the Make in India program, the country has identified 25 areas where FDI would be permitted. I'm particularly proud to announce to the audience that the well-being and the prosperity of Indian farmers and food security of India has received major priority in this year's annual financial budget. The Indian farmer is the pride of India and the primary driver of the Indian economy as well. As a government, we are committed towards ensuring that the hardships endured by the Indian farmers are well compensated. I am proud to say that this government has taken initiative to transform the ecosystem of food processing activities in the country. We have all allowed 100% FDI in the food processing sector through the automatic route. We have also undertaken policy initiatives that would pave the way for prospective investors to invest in the food processing industry. And as far as Canada and India are concerned, I think we have immense scope in the sectors of cold chain and refrigeration, where you're experts in that sector from Canada, and our government is working towards creating a cold chain grid throughout the country for seamless transfer of food from production to consumption. And I think with the exchange of technology and the know-how that you could bring into our country, it could actually lead to stronger economic ties in this sector. I appeal to all the business and research community from Canada and India to join hands in helping create a unique ecosystem of food processing and supply chain in the country. These are immense opportunities for investors in mega food parks, cold chain infrastructure, and creation of backward and forward linkage in this sector as well. I would like to emphasize here today to potential Canadian investors that India is a land of opportunities. The country is going to witness a huge spurt in economic growth and industrial activities. We invite our friends from Canada to become a part of India's next phase of economic growth story. And I would also like to end here by inviting the Honorable Prime Minister for a longer stay next time. Prime Minister, sir, the doors are sealed, but believe me, if they were to be left open, this room would be bursting at its seams for the love that our people would like to show to you. And especially the people of Punjab, who welcomed you with open arms yesterday at the Golden Temple, and you have a very special place in their hearts. And we thank you for all the support that you have given to our community and the way you have welcomed our people in your land. With these words, I hope to see you here, and I hope that your family has a wonderful stay in India. Thank you so much.